In the metals quadrant, taking a look at the March gold contract, which hit two-week highs today, up about a third of a percent at 1843.30. That's the highest level in actually about 11 or 12 trading days. Gold is now up four of the last five sessions, just missed being up five consecutive sessions. It's also up seven of the last 10 sessions since hitting its 2022 low print of 1780.60 on January 28th. The total move off that low has been about 3 1/3%, and gold also closed above 1800 in the last eight consecutive sessions. Didn't get anywhere near that on the lows today, down about 0.8% at 1821.80. And while we finished negative, again, that was mostly in toward the close, and it almost finished above its open while still finishing negative to yesterday's close. But overall, we're going to have a low and a weak enough move where you can call it negative, but I really call it kind of unchanged on the day. Inflation figures came out this morning, and that helped gold get a tailwind with its historical inflation fighting or inflation hedging capabilities. The year-over-year headline and core CPI in the U.S. both came in higher than expectations. We got a 7.5% print on the year-over-year headline, a 6% print on the year-over-year core. Again, both of those well over expectations. And then even the month-over-month was about 0.2 higher than was expected. So overall, strong inflation figures, buying gold, tailwind for gold because of its inflation hedging nature. Now, also the dollar moved lower despite a move higher in rates. The dollar was very strong early in the session, but then it did move lower and finish negative on the day against most of the majors. Two-year notes went from 136 to 154, and then the 10-year note actually moved above 2%. So despite these higher yields, the dollar ended up lower, and that gave gold a tailwind as well again, even though it finished pretty much unchanged on the day, but slightly lower than yesterday's settlement.